John Busby with the Culture Buzz, and you know I love history, especially when the history is exceptionally well written. Well, I've got a gem of a book for you to consider reading. In fact, it's not a consideration. I'm going to demand that you read this book. Owen Symes is my guest. He's an historian and writer, and this is, believe it or not, his debut book, and it is a masterpiece. He was our man in Washington, A History of the Obama Years. And it's thanks to our good friends at John Hunt Publishing, which, by the way, is where you can connect and get that book directly, johnhuntpublishing.com. Also, you know me, go to your local independent bookseller, because this is one that will be flying off the shelves. Even if they're sold out of any of the current copies they did have, those independent booksellers will get your own copy if you say, please, can I get a copy? And they will get Owen Symes' copy of He Was Our Man in Washington, A History of the Obama Years, for you as well. This is a fascinating read. There's so many unique aspects of your approach to covering this history that I just marvel at, Owen. And for a debut, I mean, you found the deepest end of the pool and said, okay, if I'm going to write a book and it's going to be a debut, I can only have one debut. We're going to make it a humdinger. You did. Tell us about your background as a historian and other writing you did, which eventually led this thing to kind of manifest itself, and your muse kind of said, all right, Owen Symes, you have to write this book.
So I did a lot of college writing. Obviously, I have a BA in history from Hillsdale College, which I'm in Michigan right now. And if anyone is familiar with Hillsdale, it's a bastion of American conservatism and the liberal tradition, right? So there's a lot of critical thinking and a lot of primary source emphasis looking at the actual documents of a given time period, you know? So after college, I did a lot of kind of menial kind of work. I was a psychiatric technician. I worked in retail. I was a call center supervisor, you know, because I graduated right after the recession hit. So there weren't a lot of jobs for a history major that wasn't going into law school, say, or something like that. Yeah. So, you know, you deal with the hand you're dealt. After the 2016 election, obviously, I think that was a surprise for most people, regardless of which party you were in. I got the sense that even Republicans weren't sure Trump was going to win, as unorthodox a campaign as he ran. And so I decided, well, okay, I spent the better part of Obama's two terms in office not really paying attention to politics, much more concerned with working and getting married and things like that. So maybe a good place to start with answering the question of how do we get a reality TV star as president would be, let's start with the administration that he's succeeding. And then from there, with my kind of broad interest in history throughout college, I didn't specialize in American history. It was Western history more generally. I approached it from the perspective of, okay, let's assume that these contemporary events have a longer legacy than just 5 or 10 years. So things that Obama had to do or that he inherited from Bush, they themselves have a longer antecedents. You know, Bush is going to have to deal with the stuff that Reagan did. Who's going to have to deal with the stuff Truman did back and back and back. So at some point, you have to cut it off somewhere. But that's how I approached writing the book, was I want to give the reader a good historical context through which to judge current events. I think one of the downsides of a lot of our current political discourse is that shallowness of perspective. We can see that with the talk in Afghanistan right now. There's a lot of blame being thrown around. Oh, well, Biden didn't do this properly. Trump messed up the deal. Obama did this, or Bush shouldn't have gotten us in there in the first place. But we've been mucking around in Afghanistan since the Jimmy Carter administration, and mucking around in the Middle East as far back as FDR. So there's a legacy there that I think people often are not aware of, and that history can, I think, very often help in properly inform current discussion. So that's what I tried to convey in the book, and I think that's something unique that I bring to the analysis of the Obama administration, is just the history behind the decisions he had to make while he was in office.
Well, that was just a beautifully concise description of why I was so totally drawn to your book. I haven't finished it yet. I'm still reading. So, you know, no spoilers, okay? I know that he doesn't get elected for a third term, so we don't have to cover that.
Oh, you gave it away, no. Yeah. Twist ending.
Dang, it slipped out of my tongue. No, my guest, folks, let's start again. So I want to make sure you understand how to get your copy of this book. Owen Symes is my guest. Owen, S-Y-M-E-S. If you're someone who's into Twitter, you can connect with him at Owen_Symes, Owen_Symes. Of course, you can always go to johnhuntpublishing.com and look up He Was Our Man in Washington or Owen Symes, and you will connect with the book. Go to your local independent bookseller. Of course, you can go through the usual online outlets, but you know me, I'm just such a rebel. I just go to the publisher, go to the indies. That's what I say. But what you've done is something that, and what you've commented on is something that is sadly lacking, and that is the full breadth of context for what may be happening during a certain shortened time period. Maybe it's because the whole marketing concept of the last 50 years has been shorter, shorter, soundbite, quick this, quick that, without understanding this led to this, that led to this, that led to this, led to this, led to this. We have presidents that serve a maximum of 8 years, and they are part of, you know, threads that tie them to those 4 or 8 years. And that is, it's critically important for us to remember that and dive into it. This is what separates Our Man in Washington, A History of the Obama Years, from so many other books about Obama and about covering presidents, that I truly applaud the effort that went into this, because you did a lot of research on this. And how did you decide where threads had to, okay, I think I've covered enough this, so there's a great depth of understanding about this. How did you decide those little issues, Owen?
Wow, that's a great question. A lot of it depended on what I was trying to emphasize. So, for instance, when talking about, I have a short chapter at the end on some of Obama's interactions with American indigenous tribes, specifically regarding some of the pipeline battles that he dealt with towards the end of his presidency. Now, I could spend the books and books and books talking about the legacy of the American government's dealings with American Indians. It's a whole field of study, and there's so much that Americans like to forget, or that they aren't taught, or that we just didn't know until very recently, because it's a kind of an up-and-coming field in a lot of ways, with a lot of indigenous scholars themselves doing the research for once. It's not just white people writing about it anymore, which is very nice. But I wanted to keep that introductory section, for instance, just giving a slight background on some of these previous battles that the American government has had with indigenous people, down to a minimum, and specifically focusing more on the environmental aspect of it, taking the Black Hills to get the gold, for instance, those kinds of things, because they had more to do with battle over the pipelines and the environmental damage that those cause, and that kind of thing. So that's what I tried to do, is to focus the past specifically on the things that were most relevant to the present, because as I'm sure you can imagine, it's very easy to get bogged down in tangents and things, because most things are connected, but the connections get more and more tenuous as you get off track, and eventually you have to kind of economize to a degree. And I didn't want the reader to get too bogged down in what's supposed to be a history about Obama's time in office, with the the intricacies of the insular cases of the Philippines adventure in 1900 or something like that.
Exactly. Well, I love what you've done, which is you've helped, I think, open people's minds again to the fact that we really need to focus on the context rather than that short term, as you already have stated, but put it in the context of the continuum. Plus, we have this kind of historical chaos going on right now, where things that had previously been covered up, but still there are records and documentation of these things happening, are becoming more mainstream as far as it being acknowledged. There's also a lot of denial, too. I have to believe that historians are finding this a very stimulating time period for someone who studies history, especially in the context of what do we do with that for the now and then into the future. And this is part of the context I'm feeling in your book, He Was Our Man in Washington, History of the Obama Years, that what a great gateway subject to make people think in that broader perspective. Now, I don't know if there was a question in there or not, but maybe Owen, you can riff off that.
Yeah, I see what you mean. For instance, with the whole controversy over removing Confederate statues and monuments and things like that, there is an assumption, I think, especially among many on the right, that these statues had been erected right after the Civil War to commemorate the fallen, you know, comrades and these heroes that fought for, if not a righteous cause, then at least they fought for what they believed in. But, you know, as a matter of historical fact, the vast majority of those statues were put up either in the 1920s or in the 1960s, specifically in response to black people being too uppity. You know, there was this idea that we, the white people in the area, have to keep these black people in line. And one way to do that is to beat them over the head with our political dominance. And one way to do that is to erect monuments to the people that defended slavery. This was true in the 20s. This was true in the 60s when people were pushing back against desegregation and school busing and affirmative action and things like that. And so now in the 21st century, we have to come to grips with the fact that, you know, these statues were put in place for entirely political reasons. What a surprise. A public monument was put up for a political reason, not a scholarly one. And, you know, now we have to deal with that. And, hey, maybe these people who are traitors to the country shouldn't have monuments to them. You know, if you're so concerned about the history, read a history book about it. But, of course, now we're having trouble with that because we can't teach whatever critical race theory happens to be for a given politician. You know, so you're right. There's a real pushback against teaching these things that either were known or are becoming much better understood as time goes on. And that's a part of historical continuity too. You know, if we go back to how the Civil War was studied in, you know, 1870s, 80s forward, that was dominated by this lost cause ideology, you know, where, you know, the whole idea was that the Confederacy could have won, that the Union was evil and that kind of thing. And of course, that influenced the backlash to the Civil Rights Movement, which influenced the Reagan administration and the War on Drugs, which in turn influenced the Obama administration, because one thing he had to deal with, and I think failed to deal with, was the war on drugs. You know, this campaign to incarcerate people, mostly low-level drug offenders, for, you know, marijuana violations or crimes that don't really have any victim but the person that happens to use it. Yeah, you know, so it disproportionately affected black people. You would have hoped that the first black president could have done something about that, but partly because he thought the war on drugs was worth fighting, and partly because of the limitations of his office, he's dealing with 50 years of bureaucratic and institutional inertia, wasn't a whole lot he could do about it. Of course, that was made worse by the Republicans not willing to compromise on anything that he did, which, again, part of the legacy of racism in this country. It's not like all Republicans are racist, but it helped solidify the resistance that Obama was black and could therefore be considered, you know, an other, an un-American kind of person, you know?
Exactly. This is a brilliant book, folks. It's something that I really think is a required reading for anyone who wants to understand in a much broader historical context what the presidency of Obama was like. Owen Symes is the author of He Was Our Man in Washington, A History of the Obama Years. It is available through John Hunt Publishing. Just go to their website, johnhuntpublishing.com. Of course, you can always go to your local independent bookseller and just say Owen Symes, S-Y-M-E-S, has this great book out. He Was Our Man in Washington, and they will get a copy for you for sure. I would like to think that maybe I'm just too much of a Pollyanna, even at my age, silver lining this and that. But just as families have those skeletons in their closets and really should be revealed so that a family faces what they have in their history, America has a huge closet with a lot of skeletons. And we can't flood the, you know, the spotlight with these skeletons, but we need to have a reckoning of some sort that has to be out there. This is my personal feeling. And I want to say that one thing that came from the Obama years is kind of the beginning of opening that giant American closet. Am I missing something here, Owen?
Wow, that's an excellent question. The Obama administration, at least at the beginning of it, definitely opened up the possibility for additional progress, at least in terms of getting historically marginalized people more into the halls of power. Now, of course, the flip side of that is there was a concerted backlash, and that has not abated, unfortunately. So I think the key question of the next generation or so of American politics is going to be, who's going to win out there? Are we going to be able to deal with our racist past and our genocidal past and all these misadventures and mistakes and legit policy decisions that people thought were correct at the time? Can we deal with all that stuff as a country and move forward? Or are we going to be stuck in this never-ending cycle of refusing to deal with this stuff, and the pressure keeps building and it just doesn't go away? Because we tried to deal with this in the 60s. We tried to deal with this in the 1860s. And, conservative elements keep pushing back. And maybe it's because I've been through two recessions and a plague before the age of 35, but I'm not so optimistic. But I can't be cynical about it. Politics is very hard to predict. And America is full of very, talented and invigorated and enlightened people as well. So I hope for the best, but it's not going to be easy. That's for sure.
Well, folks, this book will be on one level, its initial level, a fantastic read, a great understanding that has never been out there before. He Was Our Man in Washington, A History of the Obama Years. But what Owen Symes has done with his fantastic debut, I still find it hard to believe it's a debut, Owen, okay? I'll just have to confess. But it is going to get you thinking. And this, if there was any book I could recommend for a group of readers, a book club group that really wants to dive into dialogue, this is a great book to do it. Go to johnhuntpublishing.com. And just look up Owen Symes, S-Y-M-E-S. He Was Our Man in Washington, A History of the Obama Years. This is fantastic reading, informative reading, thought-provoking reading. It's the kind of reading that we all need to use as we go and really explore the best possibilities for the future and not keep making mistakes. History seems to be filled with those kind of lessons, isn't that true, Owen?
Yeah, often it doesn't repeat itself, but it often rhymes. So maybe we can start a new stanza, right?
That's true. Owen, thank you so much for gifting us with this this incredible book. He Was Our Man in Washington, A History of the Obama Years by Owen Symes. Get your copy, folks. Thank you very much, Owen.
Yeah, thank you for having me.